वर्ल्ड वाइड हॉर्सेस एंड पर्टिकुलरली ट्रांसमिशन इट कैन बी थ्रू द एज यू आर विद द नेम यू आर सीइंग दैट इट इज द रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक्ट इन्फेक्शन पर्टिकुलरली सो इट विल बी ट्रांसमिटेड थ्रू द रेस्पिरेटरी रूट बाय डायरेक्ट एंड इनडायरेक्ट कॉन्टैक्ट एंड द एरोसोल ड्रॉपलेट्स और इट कैन बी ऑल्सो ट्रांसमिटेड बाय द फोमाइट्स पर्टिकुलरली क्लिनिकल एंड पैथोलॉजिकल सीन्स Here there will the mild respiratory disease in young horses up to 2 years of age and the incubation period is 2 to 10 days. There will be fever, mild depression, nasal discharge and rhinitis, pregnant heirs abort and the latent infection of trigeminal ganglia occur with equine herpes virus 4. Again you are seeing that the nerves are being involved. So there it is ganglia infected that is the trigeminal ganglia is infected in case of equine herpes virus 4 infection. So particularly in case of diagnosis you will be collecting nasal swabs, whole blood or the sera. When going for the virus isolation, in case of virus isolation we can perform it in the cell lines of the equine origin. Particularly the important thing is the equine herpes virus 4 used to grow in the cell lines or the cell cultures of the equine origin only. So we have to use the primary equine kidney, equine dermal fibroblast or equine lung fibroblast. And the cytopathic effect which can be observed can be the focal rounding, increasing in refractivity and detachment of the cells. Detachment of the cells means the cell lines which are being made in the or prepared in the Rous flask or in the tissue culture flask, we can say any of the flask. So the cells, they will be detaching with their surface. Otherwise, the cells, they are having the property of adhering with the surface. So once the virus infection is there, there will be the increase in refractivity. So there will be the shining from the cells and there will be the detachment of the cells and focal rounding of the cells. This is the specific cytopathic effect. So demonstration of significant increase in specific antibody between acute and the convalescent sera can be one of the diagnostic method. We can say that the particular individual or the swine was horse was affected with the equine herpes virus 4. And this equine herpes virus 4 is antigenetically related with the equine herpes virus 1. And conventional and serological tests do not differentiate between these two antigen. So the conventional tests are not sufficient to differentiate the equine herpes virus 1 and 4. So the specific monoclonal antibodies are available to differentiate between the equine herpes virus 1 and the equine herpes virus 4. So the monoclonal antibodies we have to use to differentiate between the equine herpes virus 1 and equine herpes virus 4. And we can also go presumptive methods, how we will be able to identify the equine herpes virus 1 is the inoculation of cell culture of equine and rabbit origin. Okay. So the equine herpes virus 1 grows in the both cell lines. But as we have seen, the equine herpes virus 4 used to grow only in the equine cell lines. So here you can differentiate between the equine herpes virus 1 and 4. So an ELISA test are nowadays available to differentiate between equine herpes virus 1 and 4 because this is very tiresome work to inoculate the virus in cell culture. We have to maintain all the precautions or to disinfections also. Other than that, we can go for the immunofluorescence, immunohistochemistry, PCR and complement fixation test. Now for the prevention of the equine herpes virus 4, modified live and kill virus vaccines are available in the market, and particularly by if we are maintaining the sound managemental practice or we are maintaining the biosecurity measures, then there are less risk of infection or we can minimize the risk of infection. So once we are purchasing the new animals or including the new horses in our shows or race tracks, we have to quarantine them for the several weeks before including them in the particular. Now, we will be talking about the equine herpes virus 3. Just we have seen about the equine herpes virus 4, we will be seeing equine coital exanthema. This equine coital exanthema is caused by the equid alpha virus 3. Equid alpha virus, the rest of the classification is the same and the species is only equid alpha virus 3. So particularly it occurs in the breeding population of the horses worldwide, so it will be affecting. And so the transmission, as it is affected in the breeding population, so the transmission will be the coitus or by the flies feeding on infectious vaginal discharge. Okay, so the incubation period is 2 to 10 days and the clinical and the pathological clinically similar to infectious pustular vulvovaginitis or balanoprostatitis of cattle. Yesterday we have seen that infectious bovine rhinotracheitis, that is the bovine herpes virus 1 was there, and this bovine, so the clinical features of the equine herpes virus C is similar to the bovine herpes virus 1. So the pustular vesicles and ulcer on the mucosa of the vulva, vagina, penis and pubis can be noticed. Okay, pustular vesicles and ulcers on the mucosa of the genital tract is noticed. So diagnosis, how we will be performing the, again the scraping from the mucosa of vulva, penis, acute and convalescent sera we have to collect. Direct examination by electron microscopy. So demonstration of the virus, we can also go for the virus neutralization test and virus cultivation in the cell cultures of equine origin. Okay, so now you are knowing which are the cell cultures of equine origin. Now prevention, vaccines are not available. So once the vaccines are not available, we have to maintain the strict quarantine or strict biosafety levels. Affected horse should be isolated and mating should be discontinued until ulcers are completely healed. So these are the, we can say, large animals. Now I will be discussing two important diseases which are caused by the herpes virus 1. And the first important disease is the Marek's disease. And the second one is infectious laryngotracheitis. So today we will be continuing with the this only herpes virus. So Marek's disease, again, when we will be talking about the order herpes village, family alpha herpes viridae, and subfamilies alpha herpes viridae. And genus, you can see it is Mardi virus. And the species with the Galid herpes alpha herpes virus 2. Galid alpha herpes virus 2 is responsible for causing Marek's disease. So particularly Marek's disease is important. About the Marek's disease, this question was asked to me when I was, I think 24 year back, when I have completed all my MBSC and I was giving exams for the PSC. Okay, so some of the experts asked me, did you know about the Marek's disease and what is its specificity? So this Marek's disease is, and at that time I replied so that I got the first position also in the PSC. So the Marek's disease is a cutaneous lymphoproliferative disease. Particularly, it will be multiplying in the lymph nodes of the chickens caused by highly cell associated. Okay, so this will be responsible with the cell mediated immunity. It is highly cell associated oncogenic herpes virus, Galid herpes virus 2. So Marek's disease is a contagious lymphoproliferative disease of chickens caused by highly cell associated oncogenic herpes virus, Galid herpes virus 2. So particularly here it will be, the immunity will be cell mediated because the virus is cell associated. Cell mediated immunity means T cells mediated immunity. So the synonym for the Marek's disease is neural lymphomatosis or foul paralysis. Again, it is caused by Galid herpes virus 2 and worldwide in distribution in domestic fowls, turkey and quails. Particularly it occurs most often in the chicks of 8 to 20 weeks of age. 8 to 20 weeks of age. And the genus Mardi virus. Mardi virus, we are talking about the Marek's disease. So this Mardi virus is immunologically divided into three serotypes. They are known as serotype 1, serotype 2, and serotype 3. So the serotype 1 is the Gallid herpes virus 2 and includes all pathogenic strains and attenuated variants derived from this strain. So जो भी pathogenic strains होंगे इसके Marek's disease के, serotype 1 is Gallid herpes virus 2, which includes all pathogenic strains and attenuated variants derived from this strain. Now the serotype 2 is Gallid herpes virus 3, and it contains a naturally avirulent and non-oncogenic strain. Naturally avirulent and non-oncogenic strains, they are coming as the serotype 2, and it is known as the Gallid herpes virus 3. Now the serotype 3 is represented by a related avirulent herpesvirus of Turkey, Malagrates herpesvirus 1. Okay, so the serotype 1, which is Gallid herpesvirus 1, is pathogenic and all the attenuated variants derived from them. Serotype 2 contains naturally avirulent, so there won't be any pathogenicity and non-oncogenic strain. So there won't be any cancer there, and or the oncogenesis or tumor forming cannot be there. And the type 3 is again the avirulent, and it is the herpes virus of Turkey or Malagrate herpes virus. So it is related with the herpes virus of Turkey and Malagrate herpes virus 1. So that's why initially for the Marek's disease, the vaccine was Malagrate herpes virus 1, or the Turkey herpes virus vaccines was used for the vaccination of Marek's disease. Now the transmission. So the transmission is via the respiratory tract through contact with viral contaminated airborne dust particles. Okay, airborne dust particles, because the virus is also present in the dandruff and the feather follicles. So the viral replication and release occur in the epithelial cells of the feather follicle, and copious amount of infectious virus are shed in dust and dandruff. So the virus is present in the feather follicles, epithelial cells of the feather follicles. So once there is shedding of the feathers will be there, and a lot amount of virus will be in the environment due to airborne dust particle. So again, you can see in the herpes virus, they are affecting the nervous system. So again, these herpes virus is responsible for motor paralysis resulting from the effect of virus replicating on the peripheral nerves. So virus is replicating on the peripheral nerves, so there will the motor paralysis will be there. So that's why you will be able to see here the particularly synovial nerves are being paralyzed. So, or there will be the thickening of the nerves, it can be sciatic, not synovial, sciatic nerves. There will be the thickening of the sciatic nerves mainly. So, there can be the paralysis. So, depending on the nerves affected, there may be signs of progressive paralysis in the neck, wing, or legs. So, once the nerves are being infected, so one lacks, particularly the legs nerves, which are the sciatic nerves, are infected. There will be enlarged peripheral and autonomic nerves. Particularly, they appear yellow and translucent. जो भी नर्व्स में क्या होगा, इन्फ्लेमेशन और एनलार्जमेंट, तो दे विल बी बिकमिंग येलोइश एंड ट्रांसलूसेंट कलर. एंड एक्यूट विसरल ट्यूमर्स पर्टिकुलरली इन द गोनेट्स, किडनी, लीवर, लंग, मसल, स्किन, वर्स्ट लाइ विदाउट एनी क्लिनिकल साइंस ऑफ पैरालिसिस. सो इन केस ऑफ एक्यूट विसरल ट्यूमर्स आर बीइंग देयर, सो देयर कैन बी द एनलार्जमेंट ऑफ द नर्व्स. ओके, वन थिंग इज एनलार्जमेंट ऑफ द नर्व्स कैन बी देयर. In case of acute visceral tumors, the tumors can be seen in the gonads, kidney, liver, lung, muscle, and skin, and burst die without any clinical signs of paralysis. Occasionally, the eye may be affected, resulting in the blindness, and this form of the particularly disease is referred known as the ग्रे आई और ऑक्युलर लिम्फोमैटोसिस, ग्रे आई और ऑक्युलर लिम्फोमैटोसिस. सो द क्लिनिकल साइंस पर्टिकुलरली देयर विल बी लेबर्ड ब्रीदिंग, देयर विल बी लेबर्ड ब्रीदिंग, लेमनेस, पैरालिसिस, इनकोऑर्डिनेशन, ब्लाइंडनेस, पेलनेस, प्लेन स्केलिकोम्स, ग्रीनिश डायरिया. ओके, द पेल comb can be there, it is not pinkish, there will be the pale comb. Blindness can be noticed, incoordination is there, incoordination with there, and lameness is there, and paralysis, labored breathing. Here you can see the labored breathing. Labored breathing means particularly the birds are opening the mouth and gasping, and the diarrhea is greenish. So the diagnosis, particularly for the diagnosis, we can, as the birds, particularly in case of poultry, generally the poultry which are being affected, or the large amount of poultry are affected, numbers of poultry are affected, so representative birds are being sent for the postmortem. So whole bird can be sent, or its blood can be sent, or on the basis of the clinical scenes and the characteristic microscopic lesions, we are able to diagnose. Here you can see the enlargement of the nerve. Here you can see the enlargement of the nerve enlargement, that is also known as neuronal lymphomatosis. This is the normal nerve. And when there will be the infection of Marek's disease, which is the enlargement. So here you can see how much enlargement of the nerve is there. So once for that, you can go for the direct examination. Other than that, virus cultivation. So the for the cultivation of the virus, we can use the primary cell cultures of the chicken embryo kidney, duck embryo fibroblast, we can use that. So the characteristics, focal area of cytopathic effect, termless blocks usually appear in 3 to 5 days. So one thing you can see, the CPE, when we are inoculating in the primary cultures, then we are seeing it is a plaque formation. But when we are inoculating into the embryonated egg, and the lesions, they are focal lesions, they are known as the POC lesions. Here we are seeing the plaque in particularly cell lines. So detection of viral antigen in preparation of skin or feather tips using the radial precipitation test or ELISA. So for viral antigen in preparation of skin, particularly how we can be detecting, so we have to prepare that, particularly if we have to detect the viral antigen, we have to extract the antigen from the skin or the feather tips, and we will be using the radial precipitation test or ELISA for detection of the viral antigen. So this is all about the Marek's disease. And one more terminology in the Marek's disease, it is known as the MARSA, that is the Marek's disease tumor associated antigen. The antigen which is present or the, is known as the MARSA, Marek's disease tumor associated antigen, is detected in case of Marek's disease. Now we will be talking about the another important disease of the poultry, which is caused by the herpes virus, and it comes under the genus Iltovirus, and the species is Galid herpes virus 1. So in the Marek's disease, we have seen Galid herpes virus 2 for the Marek's disease, and Galid herpes virus 1 is responsible for causing ILD. So again, it will be worldwide disease of chickens and pigeons, transmitted by direct and indirect contact or through aerosol routes. And incubation period is generally 6 to 12 days. Again, it is mild to severe respiratory disease in young and older birds. So both are types. And infection involves principally the larynx and trachea, resulting in coughing, gasping, and dyspnea. Infected birds may cough up to blood stained mucus. So if in birds you are finding coughing, gasping, and dyspnea, difficulty in respiration, and sometimes blood stained mucus, you can think of infectious laryngitis. And intranuclear inclusion bodies are seen in the epithelial of the trachea. If we are making the smear from the trachea and or we are performing the histopathology from the tissue of the trachea, we will be able to see the intranuclear inclusion bodies. Mild sinusitis and conjunctivitis can be noticed, and the principal lesion is tracheitis. It means inflammation in the trachea. So, particularly diagnosis, clinical specimen, we have to collect the trachea and lung. On the basis of the clinical signs, finding of typical herpes virus intranuclear inclusions, electron microscopic examination of distal water lysate of tracheal scrapings. Only we have to collect the tracheal scrapings and we have to get the distal water. Then FAT can be performed and virus cultivation. So, virus cultivation can be done on the CAM route of the embryonated chicken and the membrane become thickened and white blobs are noticed. ELISA, ADID, real-time PCR, RFLP PCR, there are different, they can be used to differentiate the virus or the field strain from the vaccinated strain. One more thing I want to mention in case of ILT is that, as you have seen, there will be the difficulty in respiration or the difficulty in respiration or gasping. So the disease condition is also known as the pump handle respiration. Pump handle respiration, or so you have seen the hand pump. Hand pump dekha sab koi ne? Hand pump ko handle ko kaise apan upar niche karte hain? So वैसे ही bird pura upar niche ho jata hai respiration mein. एक बार सिर ऊपर ले जाएगा, then it will be beginning down, then it will be taking it up, then it will be coming down. So जैसे that is known as the pump handle respiration or the ILT. So the prevention, modified live vaccine administered in drinking water or by aerosol sprays, birds that return from the disease may remain latently infected. Disease. So these were the important disease of the herpes virus which I have continued up till now. So this is again the new disease, malignant catarrhal fever. It is caused by genus Macca virus. And the family, you can see subfamily is also changed. That is the gamma herpes virus. Macca virus, genus is Macca virus and binomial name is Alcephaline gamma herpes virus 1 or ovine gamma herpes virus 2. So the disease is caused by two of the viruses, that is the Alcephaline gamma herpes virus 1 or ovine gamma herpes virus 2. So particularly malignant catarrhal fever is an sporadic acute frequent fit of cattle, deer and some wild ruminants. Particularly characterized by, caused by two related virus, but distinct gamma herpes viruses, Alcephaline herpes virus 1 and ovine herpes virus 2. So the natural host for the Alcephaline herpes virus 1 is the wild beast, while for the ovine herpes virus 2 is the sheep. And the infection in the natural host is common in subclinical, particularly, and the wild beast, particularly, the virus in cattle and farm deer is referred to as wild beast associated malignant catarrhal fever or sheep associated malignant catarrhal fever. So the distribution of the Alcephaline herpes virus 1 is largely confined to Africa and zoological gardens, while ovine herpes virus 2 occur in sheep and goats worldwide. So there is differentiation between Alcephaline herpes virus 1 and ovine herpes virus 1. The transmission for two cattle and deer from sheep that shed virus during lambing via the respiratory route. So both vertical and horizontal transmission can be noticed. Four clinical forms are there. They are the paracute form, head and eye form, intestinal form and the mild form. This is the head and eye form. There will be the reddened eyelid. Okay, here you can see the red and eyelid. Bilateral corneal obesity. crusty muscles and ears. Here you can see the crusty muscles and ears. Nasal discharge here you can see, and salivation can also be noticed. This is the early sign in head and eye form. But in the later stage, erosion of the buccal mucosa can also be, here you can see erosions, just like in case of FMD, but it is on the dorsum of the tongue. In case of FMD, the erosions of the tongue is there, but it is on the, not on the whole tongue, it is on the dorsum of the tongue. Now, I'm not going in much more details about the clinical and the pathological features. Clinical signs in bovidi, joints, superficial lymph node swelling can be there. Horn, hoof covering, stuffing is there. Nervous sign, incoordination, head pressing, nystagmus and hyperesthesia. Things are performing the postmortem. So, the erosion on the tongue and the soft hard palate. Soft and the hard palate in the tongue, erosions of the tongue and soft and the hard palate can be noticed. Postmortem, necrotic area in the omasal epithelium and multiple erosions in the intestinal epithelium can be noticed. Here the multiple erosions you can see in the intestinal and necrotic areas can also be there in the omasal epithelium. Necrotic areas and multiple erosions. Greatly enlarged lymph node compared to the normal. This is the normal, this is the enlarged lymph nodes. And the necrotic areas in the larynx, that is the diphtheritic membrane, is often present in case of larynx. Okay, so the diphtheritic membranes, yesterday I have talked about the diphtheritic membrane formation in case of fowl pox. Here, today we are seeing the diphtheritic membrane formation in case of ILD. Here now in case of particularly that is the ulcerfaline herpes virus. So urinary bladder mucosa, hypermic and edematous. Once you are seeing the urinary bladder, its mucosa will be hybrid and edematous. Kidney often has raised white foci on the cortex. Okay. For the diagnosis, clinical signs or the clinical specimen, we can collect the Buffy coat, fresh thyroid and adrenal gland tissues, virus isolation from the bovine thyroid cells. So molecular detection of the ovine herpes virus 2 by the DNA by PCR, immunofluorescence and immunoperoxidase test can also be performed. While the serological diagnosis, competitive inhibition ELISA for the detection of serum antibodies to ulcerfaline herpes virus 1 or ovine herpes virus 2. So we have to perform the competitive inhibition ELISA. This competitive inhibition ELISA can also be performed in case of FMD also. And that time when there is the solid phase and the liquid phase ELISA is there. Now you have to differentiate with the bovine mucosal disease, bovine viral diarrhea or the mucosal disease, blue tongue virus, cinder-based virus, FMD, vesicular stomatitis, salmonellosis, pneumonic complex, oral exposure to caustic material, mycotoxicosis and poisonous plants. That's why the laboratory diagnosis is important. Otherwise, you will be confusing with so many diseases. Vaccines are not available. Cattle should be separate from the sheep. Now, the duck viral enteritis. A little bit, one or two slides, I will be showing about the duck viral enteritis. So, the duck viral enteritis is again caused by the Mardi virus. Mardi virus, the virus which was causing the herpes disease, that Marek's disease, is now responsible for causing the duck viral hepatitis also, or particularly duck viral enteritis. So, a duck viral enteritis is responsible. This is for the Mardi virus or herpes virus, duck viral enteritis. So, duck herpes virus 1 and anted herpes virus 1 are responsible for causing the disease. And the synonym is duck plague, anted herpes virus 1. Commercial geese, ducks, and wild fowls are affected. It is both by the direct and in the indirect contact. Water contaminated with feces is the main source of the infection because ducks are in the bottom. So, there will be the oculonasal discharge, Photophobia, depression, inappetent thoughts, and watery, bloody skin, diarrhea can be noticed. Our diagnosis, clinical specimen, pulled up our liver and the mesenteric lymph node. On the basis of clinical signs and high death losses, there can be the intranuclear infusion, fluorescent antibody test can be performed, and virus cultivation. So CAM or the duck embryonated egg, we die 4 days after the inoculation. So there will, once you will be seeing the CAM, you will be inoculating the CAM via the CAM route into the duck embryo. So for the particularly prevention, modified live and kill virus vaccines can be used, and string avoidance of contact with the wild waterfowl is the preventive method. So today with this, the herpes virus is over for you. I think herpes